Well, a secret's out now that episode 601 is finally premiered, so we can get the dirt on dirty deeds from Jake Doyle himself.
Starting now.
I'm up for staff sergeant next year.
Well, congratulations, staff sergeant.
Don't make fun.
I'm not making fun. I like the idea of you being more authoritative. Although, it does put a damper on the whole new babies thing.
2 minutes, I said.
I'm joking, but I'm joking. Too bad I'm going away for murder.
What did you say?
I didn't kill anyone, Leslie. I need your help.
Okay, first of all, I love the dream sequences. You know I love them.
Yeah, they're cool. And there's been like a... Through the years of the show, there's always been like a small dream element because I've always kind of felt like we have a bit of clarity in our... I don't think we see the future or anything, but we can have a clarity of what we truly want sometimes in our dreams. Yeah.
This is like some insight into Allan Hawco now.
Yeah, and I think that there's also, if you notice for the super geeks out there, there's like another whole element of like the string theory, the super string theory, which is now just string theory, kind of mixed in there. So there's alternate.
I'm going to have to super this part.
Yeah.
What's the string theory now?
Oh, string theory, like multiverse universes, like the idea that we live in a, you know, fundamentally we've always thought that we live in a three-dimensional universe, but with... quantum physics, there's a theory called string theory.
This is CNBC, boy.
Yeah, I know. But there's like a thing where there's potentially an infinite amount of multiverse universes that we're all living in.
Okay, gotcha.
And every possibility in those multiverse universes is possible.
So what are you telling me? That was real? That's what's going to happen?
I'm saying that in some multiverse universe, that could be happening right now. But I don't know if that happens to Jake and Leslie. I actually do know. It's all on that laptop. If you knew my passcode, you could figure it out.
All I know is what the fans want, and it's love, sweet love.
Yeah, we all want a bit of love.
Yeah. I don't mean, again, it's CNBC.
I was supposed to try to kiss you there?
No, sir.
Or
but
the
I,
microphone.
Well, no, but here's the thing. We want Jake and Leslie to end up together.
Do we?
Well, I do.
Yeah, but you know, sometimes we don't always get what we want.
But I've been 5 seasons now saying that same thing. Eventually, love is going to happen.
Yeah, I think that there's a good chance that they will have some kind of connection. She's messed up. She was buried alive. And she's going to be, you know, that's not going to be easy for her to deal with. I mean, he saved her life, which I'm sure she won't forget.
Right. That's not the first time, though.
No, he saved her life a couple times. And
yeah.
She was never buried alive before. That was intense. I rewatched a little while ago.
Did you cry?
When we did,
I know you cried the first time.
We did a DVD commentary. I didn't cry, but I had tears. Like, I was like, oh, man, that's kind of a moving moment. And I showed it to Scott Grimes, who's guest starring this season, who plays Jimmy.
Jimmy O'Rourke. Huge fan following for Jimmy.
Isn't he fantastic?
Yes.
And I showed him that last sequence. We all watched it while I was cutting episode one. And, yeah, you know, everyone just kind of shuts up and watches and kind of goes into a freeze frame. It was a great moment of television. I'm really proud of that.
Yeah, you should be.
Yeah.
Should be. Okay, so now let's just talk about it, because you sort of broached the subject of guest stars. Everybody wants to be in this last season, and you've got huge names.
There's a lot of exciting people. I think that it's our final season, right, as we know, and there's 10 episodes, which I don't think we could have done more than 10. I don't think we physically could have handled more than 10. Last year we did 16, and it was like...
That was supersized.
Yeah,
right?
I
call it that.
It almost broke. I was happy to give our audience more of the show, but it also broke us down a little bit. So we really wanted to do 10 episodes. And within that 10, you start to get really picky about all of the amazing characters that you want to bring back and people that you want to introduce and explore. And it all comes down to what the story demands.
Right.
So
who can we see?
You'll see, for sure, you'll see Alan Doyle, you'll see Scott Grimes, you'll see an amazing actor named Carly Pope, who has a really cool arc throughout the series, Ron White. Of course, Lola Tash comes back, who, you know, she plays Sloane.
Right.
Even though she ripped off the Doyles.
I was going to say.
Yeah. So you'll see
so
her.
So she comes back.
Yeah, you'll get her.
Okay.
And then Sean Doyle, who plays Carl Murray.
Love him.
the wrongfully convicted.
Is it wrong that I love Carl Marr?
No, he's fantastic.
Yeah, he's a great character.
And he's a brilliant actor, Sean.
Oh, Sean Doyle, come on.
Of other greats. Jason O'Mara, of course, was in the premiere, and that was kind of cool. I'm a big fan of his.
Yes. Okay, so here's the other thing, and you mentioned Carly Pope. So many of those people loved their time here, not just being on the set, but being in St. John's and experiencing this.
It's going to be sad, you know, that we, like Scotty coming here every year. He's like one of my best friends. He gets to come here and hang out.
Yeah.
And we spend time together and we work. And, you know, that all kind of ends. That all ends very soon.
But Alan Hawco, Take the Shot doesn't end. And no. I got to believe that you're, because I'm running into people going, I sent my script to Take the Shot. I'm like, oh, yeah, very good. While you're there, can you talk to... I'm like, no, I don't do that. but you must be getting pitches now, left, right, and center, to do other stuff.
Yeah, and we are very careful about the things that I'm writing or Perry's writing, and whether we're writing them together or we're creating new series on our own, whether we're doing comedy stuff with Mark Critch, we're doing... you know, we have books that we've optioned. We're developing with CBC. We're developing with the other privates as well. And, you know, there's lots of potential for us, and we're working on that. And I want to make sure that the next thing we do is something that we're in love with. And,
right.
You know.
And now talk about the next thing. This won't be the end. I know we talk about episode 610 like it's the end. But
right.
Please tell me that that's not the end.
I think that you will... I'm not interested in letting the Doyles go.
Okay, good.
I'm not interested in letting Jake go. So I'd definitely put on our priority list movies, making movies of the show. I definitely would do it.
Right.
And I think that's something we're going to do.
Good.
Yeah, I think that's safe to say. I mean, it'd be fun to do it. It'd be fun to visit and revisit these characters again, having had a bit of time away from them, being able to focus on some other things. And also my life, you know, I haven't had a... I'm certainly grateful in every way, shape, or form.
Will you take a break?
Not really, but I mean...
So.
I mean, if I go do a job...
Right.
If I just go write on something, or if I go write something or act in something, that's a job.
Right.
That would be a vacation for me.
Right, because you're not doing 900 things.
Yeah.
You're doing one. Well, I remember, and we'll be looking forward to, this is just a little off topic, but the Book of Negroes is coming out.
January.
I mean, come on.
I think they have our time slot. I think they take, because it's six parts, so they'll pick up, I think, on Wednesday nights. I think. I'm not 100% sure on that, but that's the notion I got.
Now, I'm asking everybody this question, and for the creator of the show, how hard would this be? But I'm going to ask him, your favorite episode in the six seasons? Well, maybe just five now, because we don't know what you're shooting for six, but let's just say...
Yeah, the first five.
First
208 is one of my favorites.
Just it's tell me who was
Martin
in
it. Poole, and it was like a bounty hunter, and Dez gets tased three times, and Leslie and Jake are doing a scene right there by the door, and the biker's got a gun to the door.
That was such a good scene, because you said go away.
Yeah.
I was thinking, I can't stop thinking about you, about us. Why are we doing this? Why are we doing this, Jake? Why are we hiding from the truth? It's stupid. Have you ever thought, what if you and me? I mean...
No. I haven't. So, go away now.
What?
Just go away. Leslie, I don't want you here. Go away. Go away. Bye. See ya.
Jake, what are you...
Look, what do you want me to say? Okay, we gave it a shot, and you, you kind of broke my heart, so what's left to, debate about, right? Just like you to leave. Leave! Please!
I'm sorry.
Jake has a lie to her.
And then they're right on this desk at the end, remember? Yeah. And he tells her that he loves her, and they have the scotch, and she's touching his...
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
That was right here.
Yeah.
Get it. Can you, Ty, get that? Just shoot that. Just pan over. There. See? Romantic. Am I right? I love that moment.
Yeah, that's kind of cool. That's one of my favorite episodes.
I don't I don't think I'm going to be able to leave here today without taking, like, stuff. Is that all right?
What do you want?
Well, I don't know. Oh, that brings up another thing. Are you going to have, like, an auction, or should you hold on to it for future production?
We're holding on to it. Well, everything, you know, we need to hold on everything we own because, yeah, we're a production company, so.
You know how many people have been tweeting about buying the GTO, right?
Yeah, they're not getting it. Yeah, that kitchen over there is from my old house. My wife came in one day, and she was like, why is our kitchen in here?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
So if you could say one thing to the fans out there, what would it be? Allan Hawco, go.
You're making me all emotional now.
I know. I'll get the Kleenex, Brit.
I'm serious. No, just thank you. It's a miracle that people kind of bought into the show we were making and followed us and supported us, and without that, we would have nothing, and I'm really, really, really grateful, and I can't express it any more than that without starting to cry like a big baby.
Well, we're grateful to you.
Thank you. Thank you.